Before we start today's tutorial, I just wanted you to know that last week's sci-fi portal tutorial didn't went out so well. I think YouTube algorithm messed up, so I'm leaving its link in the description, so do check it out as well. It's pretty amazing. I hope you guys are doing well. So today I'll be teaching you how to create this sci-fi code thing. So at the end of the video, I will show you some bonus tricks to make it look even better. So let's get started. First of all, we're going to delete the default cube. Going to front view, delete all this light too. Shift A, mesh, UV sphere, scale it a little bit inside. Going to the context render, turn on ambient occlusion and bloom. And in the world settings, set the world to completely black. Now, shift A again, and mesh and icosphere, and keep the number of subdivisions to 2. Tab into edit mode and then click space to search. If it isn't space, then go into edit, preferences, and keymap and check whatever button it is that you is used for looking using for the search functions. So search edge split, enter it. Now tab to go back into object mode, into modifiers tab, and then add this mode modifier. Then we're going to add another modifier, and this time it's going to be the solidify modifier. Bump up the strength to 0.015, and then shift A again to add a UV sphere. Scale it a little bit more, then go tab into edit mode again, and then let's split this one too. But and then we're going to give this a smooth modifier as well, but this time the factor increase it to 1.4. And click this and shade smooth it, and the icosphere as well, shade smooth it as well. So now we're going to create the materials for them. First of all, for the inner sphere, check the base material, change it into an emission material, bump up the strength to 3, and give it about this type of bluish color. Then click the outermost sphere and select the same material for it, but then click this over here to actually make it a new material. This way, when we change this material, the old one will still remain the same. And bump up this its strength to about 5. Now click the icosphere. We're going to give it a new material as well, and increase the metallic to full and roughness to 0. That's it. That's pretty much what we're going to do. Now in the rendered mode, let's have a look at it. Okay, it's about to be completed. Go back to solid mode, add in a light point, give it an orange color, give it a strength of 3000. And now in the rendered view, we're going to see, so you see it's about to affect, increase the radius to about over here. You know, all of these are now completely enveloped by the orange color. So now this was, and now for the animation part. Alright, this animation is going to be a seamless loop, but as in you can loop it over and over and it will look like it's going on forever. So first of all, take this frame to 0 over here, click on the icosphere. I guess we're going to animate it first. Go into its object data and make sure that it is on frame 0 for it to be a proper seamless loop. So click, go into rotation and click I to add a keyframe, then go to frame 250. Into the z-axis, type in 360 degree. We want it to rotate seamlessly, and then click I again for again to add another keyframe. Then you see it's actually rotating. And make sure that in preferences, before you do this, I should have told you this before. My bad. In preferences, in the animation section, that your default interpolation is linear, not constant, or not bezier or anything else. Just it should be linear. Now select the outermost circle and you know, make sure again that it is on 0, and on rotation click I to add another keyframe, and on frame 250 this time it's actually going to be in the z-axis again -360, because we wanted to go into the opposite direction, and then click I again, and now voila. So now for the secret part, where I was going to show you a few more other tricks to actually make it look slightly different or better. One of the tricks is to actually, if you want to make this make them look circular, select them and add a subdivision surface modifier to actually, you know, make them look circular. One of these, it's one of the tricks And the other one is actually a lot better. You can add a displace modifier, give it a texture, and depending on what texture you're going to give it, it's going to give you a different effect. It looks like beautiful shards over here. Vronite actually gives another shard effect. And obviously it's still animated. So I hope you guys learned something today. Please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and for another final trick, if you add more lights, GZ, give it a strength of 1000 and change it to orange. I'm actually going to remove the modifier here, and it will actually have this extra flare. If you actually add it into all four of the directions, it will actually look a lot more cooler. So I hope you guys learned something today. Like this video, subscribe to our channel. I will be creating more tutorials. So see you next time. Goodbye.